impossible to do a burnout in this car. I mean, you just can't do it. Now, maybe if we do a neutral drop.
No, not doing this.
Freaking cinematic sliding shocks of this car. Takes too long, man.
What's going on, guys? Welcome back to another video on the AutoVlog YouTube channel. I hope you're having a fantastic day. In today's upload, we're going to talk about money. You guys know that I've done this from time to time on the channel where I speak about earnings because I know that there's a lot of curiosity out there regarding YouTubers and, you know, what they make, how they make their money, and that kind of thing. So I've outlined in a few videos what type of revenue that I've earned from other videos, for instance, on the Raptor and on my F-150 and also my AMG. Today, however, it's this car's turn. This is my $500 piece of junk car, my hoopty. And you might think, how can a clunker like this generate any kind of income? Well, you'll be surprised, because I was. All right, so first we'll do a quick little walk around here. This is my, actually I forgot what year it was. If I hadn't seen the sticker, I would have forgotten. 1998 Chevy Prizm. And yeah, I don't know what else to say about it. It's a piece of junk. So some malfunctions on this car is that you can only open it from the outside. Door handle here doesn't work. You see it is unlocked. I have to reach my hand out. We got planes as usual in my videos. Also, I can't open the hood. It's completely shut. Goes without saying that air conditioning is broke. Heater works though. Now, all in all, this car is just a piece of junk. However, since I got the car, I've only made about 4 dedicated videos with just this car being featured. It's made some short little cameos in other videos on the channel, but those were never dedicated hoopty videos. So in today's video, we're actually gonna cover how much those 4 videos has generated in revenue for the channel. Remember, the car cost $500. But first, I wanna thank the sponsor of today's video, Kove speakers. Now, as you've probably figured out already, it is a Bluetooth speaker. This is the design and the size. This thing is very, very nimble. And this thing is sweet. And this is the volume right here. And it fits perfectly in a cup holder, especially in a crappy car like this that does not have Bluetooth and not, I mean, it has a functional stereo, but the stereo in this car sucks. This thing is so much better. And another thing I like about this speaker is it doesn't have a million buttons. There's 2 of them right here, on button and then a mode for indoor or outdoor, which you see right here. Yeah, this thing is sick. I love this speaker. My wife loves it as well. She's always using this thing while getting ready in the morning. It's got a subwoofer here in the back. But here's the best part. If you guys go to kovespeakers.com/autovlog, you save a pretty whopping 65% off the retail price on one of these speakers. That's 65%. I mean, it's not many times you find a discount that's high. So all you have to do is go to kovespeakers.com/autovlog. Pick one of these up for yourself, your friend, your wife, whoever it is, and save 65% off the retail price. Okay, so back to the video here. As you guys know, I do YouTube full time. It is my main source of income. And there are many times slight confusion about how YouTubers get paid and definitely how much do they make. Now, of course, goes without saying that that varies a lot from creator to creator, depending on your views and depending on your CPMs and all that stuff. Now, most YouTubers, they won't talk about money. They definitely won't show you their income. Now, while I've never talked about my full yearly income, I have, however, showed you what I can make off of certain videos. So in today's upload, we're actually going to talk about the clunker here and the four videos I've made of it and see how much revenue they've actually generated. I'm pretty surprised myself here, but it's turned out to be a pretty good investment. Okay, so if we start with video number one, and that was, of course, when I picked the car up. Now, some people weren't really happy about me buying this car. They were like, what kind of boring project car is that? But the purpose of this car was never to be a project car that I, you know, fix up and put, you know, gigantic turbos on and wheels and that kind of thing. I bought it because I wanted to more or less destroy it with what happens if videos, do crazy experiments and see how long it lasts. Now, it is still here, as you guys can see for yourselves. So that first video got, I think it has around 80,000 views, and I picked it up about 2.5-3 months ago. At the time, CPMs were kind of shaky on YouTube. I don't know if it was just me or it affected a bunch of other creators, I have no idea, but for those 80,000 views, it generated $200. So 500 minus 200, we all know I'm 300 bucks in the hole at this point. Now, video number two, I can't remember exactly what it was about, but something happened with the car, and I think I titled it that, you know, it broke already, or it's the most horrible project car on YouTube, or something like that. That video generated $124. So now the car has made me about $324, but I paid $500 for it, so I'm still in the hole. I'm starting to think, like, yeah, this was a pretty bad idea. You know, I mean, the car cost 500 bucks. I mean, how many videos is it gonna take for me to make this money back? But I hadn't started with the what happens if videos yet. So the first one we did was what happens if you put a 20-year-old car in reverse, or in park and reverse at the same time. So that video turned out to be fairly popular. It has about 500,000 views so far, and it generated. Now, I forget exactly how much it was because I did forget to send those print screens that I took off my computer to my phone so I could read them to you guys here while I was actually filming the video. But it's 970 some dollars, I think, which is okay. So CPMs are starting to go up a little bit here. The videos are earning better per 1,000 views. So we're definitely in the plus now. So instead of being about 170 bucks in the hole, we're now on top. Which then brings us to the most recent, what the hell? Oh, dang, look at the car, it's like leaking. I just noticed that right now. Oh, look at that. Oh, wow, rusted frame and everything. Yeah, this is kind of off topic. That's not what I was supposed to talk about, but it is what it is. I mean, I was planning on this car breaking at some point, but not today. I'm sure it's still drivable though. I mean, I have to say, it's probably one of the most reliable cars that I have. With all the crap we put it through, it's still running pretty good. So back to the most previous video that we did in this car right here, which was what happens if you put brake fluid in the gas tank of your car. Now, I thought the car was just completely gonna break down because brake fluid and gasoline are two different things. So anyhow, that video actually started off kind of slow. I mean, it got some views in the beginning. It had like 70,000 views after, I don't know, a week or something like that, which is kind of bad for a what happens if video. But with YouTube, you never really know what's gonna happen. Sometimes the videos take off after a while, which this video did. So a few weeks ago, it actually started getting a good amount of views. So it went from 70,000 to, I think it's around 650,000 views currently. And this video has generated over $4,000 alone from one video. So from having a few crappy videos in the beginning that didn't earn very well at all, the last video made up for it and then some. And that's how it is on YouTube. Most creators know this, especially the ones that do it full time and, you know, keep a close eye on their analytics and how their videos are performing and so on. Some videos just, they might get a good amount of views, they just don't earn much. And then other videos, like the last one here, and it doesn't really have all that many views. I mean, 650,000 is a lot, but if you compare it to many other what happens if videos I've done on the channel, I mean, 650,000 isn't all that much, but it has, however, earned more than some other what happens if videos I've done, and they have millions upon millions of views. So as you guys can see for yourselves, if we add everything up, this car right here has generated over $5,000, and it cost me 500. So it is safe to say that it was a pretty good investment in terms of, you know, fun content and then also bringing in some revenue. So there we have it, folks, some insight into what revenue making can look like for an automotive YouTuber with a crappy car like my 1998 Chevy Prizm. Now, the reason I do these type of videos is because, first, I know that people are interested in this stuff, so I know that it's pretty good content. Secondly, I do want to be somewhat transparent with you guys, so you kind of know what it looks like. You kind of know what numbers can be generated from a YouTuber. Now, I'm a, you know, average, I don't know, small YouTuber. I mean, there's other creators that are 100 times the size of the channel that I have, so you can only imagine what some of them earn. But with that being said, the car is still in one piece, although it is leaking. And me being far from a mechanic, you know, that over there, I would guess, is the fuel tank. So it's not fuel. It's not smelling either. I don't know what the hell that is. I'm sure someone will educate me in the comments. But yeah, like I said, the car is currently still in sort of one piece, although it is leaking. So there are more videos coming of the hoopty here. I do have at least one pretty big one planned for the car. Since it is leaking, I should probably try to get home as soon as possible here. I don't want to be stuck in the middle of nowhere. I do hope you guys enjoyed the video though, so let me know what you think in the comments below. If you liked it, give it a thumbs up. It actually helps. And if you're stopping in for the first time and you haven't already and you want to, please subscribe, and I'll see you guys in the next one. Bye-bye. Let's start it.